Thank you and welcome all the panelists. We'll try to make it as interactive and as, you know, probably try to involve the audience also if you have time. And so we have about 30 minutes time. I'll try to have more detailed answers from here and probably we'll interact with the audience. Is that okay with all panelists? Thank you. So, you know, I'll just quote a report from Thales, which says that 37% of respondents, you know, their respondents had experienced a data breach. I mean, your latest 2023 report, Ved, this is your report, yeah. So, you know, obviously data protection is kind of increased, I mean, has to be prioritized more because digital transformation initiatives have increased. So I'd like to start from you first in terms of, with respect to India, because this is a global report. With respect to India, do you see this number increased, less, more? What's your perspective?
So, Shrikant, I think the numbers definitely have been on the higher side and it's increasing. I think the experience from our working in the market is that there is a lot of information and talks on security around the data. We heard it with eminent panelists before also talking about network controls, talking about perimeter controls and all that. What has been not a key focus has been controls that act on the data itself. And today with the digital transformation, which is purely technology driven, and businesses, digital businesses are data driven. So the key focus lies in terms of how do you ensure a last line of defense that acts on the data itself in order to prevent you from disruptions that happen in terms of data breaches. Ransomware attacks, what are they? Why do you still prone to ransomware attack? Can anybody in the group today say that we are not able to get breach? Or we have 100% assurance that we won't get breached. Nobody will be able to tell that because there are new vulnerabilities, there are new shortcomings that keep coming. But what they should look at it, that in event of those things, what is the control that is missing, which is not there, which would have enabled me to be in, to ensure that we uphold the trust of the data that we are custodian of. And that's where I think a very important area lies to look at that piece of adoption of those technologies. With advent of journey in cloud, primarily regulators are now making it mandatory. Yeah. We keep hearing a lot of people, okay, that we are quite secured when you are on the cloud. Please do understand that cloud providers clearly have come out with very defined accountability that data at the end is customer's responsibility, whichever approach you take, whether it is infrastructure as a service, software as a service, platform as a service, the control has to be with you. Mm-hmm. In a layman terms, people who are not much aware, it's like we all live in an apartment, right? But we still keep a security of our flat, which we put lock and key that we do it. Even if apartment is secured with a lot of security checks, you don't leave that the apartment the secretary of the society will take care of my security of the flat. No, you don't. Now, this is just to give you an analogy that I am finding, and this is where we are addressing a lot of emerging growth areas, is that there is a significant need for a key management system becoming a business critical in your digital transformation journey.